today, what I have on the docket is the arena qualifier play-in, which the format today is best of three traditional Dominaria United Sealed deck. You can enter a qualifier play-in either, you know, just normally by paying gems or gold. You can also qualify by being in Mythic tier at the end of the season or through accumulating these play-in points from events. So I guess I have 20 play-in points, I think, from being Mythic the previous season and Constructed. But at any rate, I get a free entry, and I'm going to try to make the most of it. If I go 4-0, I get to play in the Arena Qualifier, which is already starting tomorrow. So Dominaria United Sealed deck. I'm going to record this as a video for the Channel Fireball YouTube channel, so I may as well start with shout-outs to my two excellent sponsors. The first is Channel Fireball itself. In addition to our YouTube channel, we're still working very hard on our CFB Pro written content, so don't hesitate to sign up for Pro. It only costs you $4.99 per month, and you can use my affiliate code Reid. Thanks also to Ultimate Guard. We're really excited to have had Frank Karsten join Team CFB Ultimate Guard. Check out the Ultimate Guard website for both their product listings and blog posts. Some fun stories from me and my teammates. It's worthwhile. All right. See what we could do. Ooh, that's some good green stuff. All right, a little Jund deck. What do we think based on those rares? All right. So white. Oh, double Phyrexian Missionary. Wow. Blue has double Essence Scatter. Joint Exploration, Phyrexian Espionage, Battlewing Mystic, Rona's Vortex. Black has cut down a couple decent creatures. Shadow Prophecy. Three Writhing Necromass. Red has Fires of Victory, Gitu Amplifier, Rod as Firebrand, Double Thrill, Double Twinferno, Double Myria's Outrider. And then green, Tail Swipe, Beast Caller. Wow, four Bog Badgers. Not that that's a great card to have four of, but at least I have some decent permanents if I can get the Defiler Vigor into my deck. Two blue, black, gold legends. And then a distribution of seven dual lands. Okay, so I think I can say I'm not playing white unless I'm playing white and black together. I notably didn't have a ton of amazing mana fixing for white. So if I go green, I have two dual lands in red and two dual lands in blue. So I could go Jund or Sultai. I guess, what if I start out by building like an everything but white deck, and then I can make cuts and smooth things out from there? I'll see how excited I am about a card like Twinferno. Okay. Well, let's say for the sake of argument that I'm going to be centered around green with a reduced need to have the other colors of mana. Probably cut down would be good enough to play with. I don't really have self mill cards for the purposes of Writhing Necromass. I mean, it's not a bad card ever, but potentially not very exciting. So again, circling back to the white, double missionary is amazing, but I feel like my white's not that deep. If I don't pair it with black, also my only fixing in white is one Sacred Peaks, and I guess one Meteorite technically. So I would just have to play like, you know, six basic planes if I wanted to play white, which is definitely not out of the question, but I don't know if I'm excited to be doing that. I feel like getting the Defiler of Vigor, the Namata, and the Quirion Beast Caller is a really good start. Okay, so for red, I have five sources of red that are sort of freebies. For black, I have, wow, only one source of black mana fixing. So let's see what the deck looks like with no black. I lose out on the kicker of Bog Badger. It's not really that big of a deal. Oh, I guess I'm probably playing all my dual lands anyway because I have the Sojourners. So this is with no plains, no mountains, no swamps. For blue, I have three freebie sources of blue mana. It's good for the Vine Shaper Prodigy, the Fires of Victory. And then 1, 2, 3, 4. If I wanted to be a base green deck, say like 5 forests. So that's only 12 lands. So I feel like I can get to another color by just adding basics. And again, I felt like those black cards were really strong though. What if I just built a core red-green deck? Potentially could include, or if I did Teemer, I could include Battlewing Mystic and Joint Exploration, these Essence Scatters. Molten Monstrosity is often going to cost me 5 mana. Like, imagine having a Bog Badger on the battlefield. Is that a good card? Enthrall to the Pit. Enthrall to the Pit might not be that bad if I do have some swamps in my deck. Games go longer, 7 mana to kill your best thing plus get some value. I do have more solid red creatures. this isn't really going to be a great deck for Gitu Amplifier, but the Goblin Picker, the Thrills. Yeah, it's mostly just normal quality red creatures, I guess. It doesn't look like a great Twinferno deck because I both don't have a lot of spells and I don't really have a lot of like trample or other combat tricks where I could like get the combo double strike kill. Garna is also a card if I played swamps and, you know, just played like a Jund deck. The main draw for adding black, I think, is going to be Nemata Primeval Warden. Only one black dual land, and I guess Meteorite. Okay, so another thing is, going back to my build a moment ago, this is 21 cards already. Granted, some of the green creatures are not amazing, like the Barkweave Crusher is not an amazing card, but it does get better given that it fits my curve well and I have Defiler of Vigor. But my point being, I'm not looking for... if I go base green like this with a lot of my green creatures to support the Defiler of Vigor, I'm not necessarily looking for a deep roster of additional cards. Like, that's what red would give me. Like, red gives me a bunch of filler level creatures if I want it, but I don't need that because I already have plenty of filler in green. So for my additional color, I'm more looking for like, what are the high highs? Stuff like this Nemata Primeval Warden, that's really good. So if I made most of my other basic lands swamps, like if I got in five swamps, then I'd have six sources of black mana plus the Meteorite. I don't even know if that's really enough to play Urg Spawn of Turg. This does give me self-mill for the purposes of the Writhing Necromasses, but I think that's like going a bit deep. Love Shadow Prophecy, I love Phyrexian Rager, I love Cut Down. Could probably get away with playing those off of, I don't know, four swamps or something. So remember, three free sources of blue mana. Urtai's pretty good. So if I added Urtai and an island or something. So this looks like a reasonable deck. Functional mana. What am I missing out on in this deck? Oh, the Rona's Vortex. Yeah, probably would have to play the Rona's Vortex. So looking more like that. I can live without Joint Exploration, Essence Scatter, Phyrexian, Espionage, Aggressive Sabotage. So I'm okay with this deck. Now let's go completely back to the drawing board and look at what it would take to get those two Phyrexian Missionaries into my deck. So this deck has pretty much just Shadow Prophecy and Aggressive Sabotage as a need to play off-color lands. The Namata is still tempting as a splash card, as is Urtai. So my card quality has gone down a lot, really paying the price for those Phyrexian Missionaries. I also don't really have a lot of removal or a lot of spells at all. So I think this deck's pretty bad. What if I was to go like full Mardu? So more of like a white-red splash black kind of thing. White-red splash everything. Thank you. Yeah, I mean, I think this is worse. I think it's just going way too far for the Phyrexian missionaries. So back to the four color green deck that I had a moment ago. And that's going to be what I'm submitting. So again, the idea here is that I'm building in such a way where green is the only color of mana I like definitely need to have in order to keep an opening hand. And the other colors are, you know, even if you don't necessarily want to call them splashes, they're non-essential. I don't have to have a basic swamp in my opening hand for my deck to function. That's the way I'm trying to design it. So I was going to play one island, four swamps, and five forests. And yeah, that's what I'm going to try. Do I like inscribed tablet? I thought I was going to play it at first. Now I'm not so sure. Okay, yeah, I'll try this. I'll try the inscribed tablet over my third copy of Bog Badger. Got a raid from Titan MTG. Thank you, Titan, and welcome to everybody who's coming from that channel. I'm just starting my sealed deck qualifier play-in event. Well, I have all my colors of mana. I had a hand like this in booster draft the other day and I mulliganed, but I think it's pretty borderline and it might be such that I'm willing to keep in sealed deck. I think it's pretty like deck dependent, matchup dependent, format dependent if you want to keep a hand like this. But yeah, I mean, all my colors of mana and a decent defensive creature, I think that's enough for me to be willing to keep. Granted, basic forest is not the ideal first draw here. Okay. Snare Spinner, the perfect foil to the Samite Herbalist. And a missed land drop from the opponent. It's a little fishy that the opponent would hit their land and then still not play anything. So maybe I could have predicted the artillery blast. It's a little specific. Not necessarily blaming myself for attacking there, but it was fishy that they would hit their third land drop and still not play anything. By the way, I'm being conservative with the Snare Spinner just because it's really bad to let the Samite Herbalist attack. So in a world where they just play a removal spell and the Nagoth Sentry, I want to have a backup. All right, so now they're hitting their stride. But so am I. Okay, well, I think I'm going to start with the Vine Shaper Prodigy with Kicker. It's happening almost no matter what. But I either have a 4-6 or a 2-2 that draws me another card. I'll go for the 2-2 that draws me another card. And then seems like I want to tail swipe the Nashoba Brawler. But if I'm to do that, then one of my 4-4 creatures could be blocked by a 2-2. So it's possible I want to do it after combat. Maybe not. It is an instant. So I guess given that it's an instant, I can just attack with these and see what my opponent chooses to do. So now tail swipe the 5/5 and the brawler, get an extra point of damage, and then sort of like win combat here. It's awesome that tail swipe is an instant. It looks like the type of card that would be a sorcery, but very powerful. So if I was to block with the Vine Shaper Prodigy, it would effectively be like trading the Vine Shaper Prodigy for their worst card and 4 points of life for myself. Normally I would do that, but I think I have an opportunity to be aggressive here, so I'm going to not block and attack back with the Vine Shaper Prodigy. All right, even being able to, well, I could cut down something, but then I can't play the Rager. I think playing the Rager is good for board presence and the counter on the Beast Caller. Oh, I get it with Tail Swipe. Okay, if it's played during your main phase, the creature gets +1/+1. So I didn't get an extra damage from the Tail Swipe, but that's okay. Coming in hot. So yeah, cut down the Herbalist and then bounce the Warhorse and attack with everything that would be lethal. Okay. Now, sideboarding is always tricky when you have access to, like, you know, 70 reasonable cards you could play with. I don't think I have any reason necessarily to change anything. A big card that I'd be considering be, like, the second Snare Spinner. maybe the Enthrall to the Pit. Do I have any answers to that Guardian of New Benalia? Yeah, I guess I'm inclined to just stand pat with what I have. Great hand. Man, the turn two Beast Caller is so nice. I wouldn't consider this to be like one of the best cards in the set, because if you draw it later, or if you draw it in an awkward hand where you don't have a lot of creatures, then it can be not so good. But in a spot like this where it's just turn two, uncontested in the context of a good draw, it's amazing. All right, well, not exactly uncontested, but still good. Sure, probably means they have Urborg Repossession or Phyrexian Missionary, something like that. Pow. I think this was a mistake. I should have just main phase played cut down. So now if they had like take up the shield or something, I get blown out. But I was a little indecisive about exactly what I wanted to accomplish on that turn. Well, could go for the win here with a counter spell backup. So that works for me. Hooray! I like that I'm getting functional mana draws. Though maybe I shouldn't speak too soon because I do need a third land. Come on, land. Right. Well, not a land, but at least something that I can cast, so I don't have to discard the hand size. Come on, land, let's go. I need to rattle off lands and Urtai that thing. I mean, 6/6 trample, and it only gets worse from there. All right, I mean, what can you really do in a game like this? Changes, any changes? Let's bring an Enthrall to the pit. Maybe I can nab that Defiler. Well, I like that I have two kind of crazy rares that I can be able to play on turn two and run away with the game. The first was the Quirion Beastcaller, the other is the Rata's Firebrand. Okay, I think I like Inscribed Tablet, Activate, and then Fires of Victory, the Vanguard. All right, does that change anything? Being able to find the Tangled Islet. No, I think I just take the islet and then still go ahead and Fires of Victory that thing. This is the Arena Qualifier play-in. I am 1-0 and down a game in match number two. So I make one of the tokens unable to block. I guess they can single block the Firebrand, and that makes me invest mana into it, so it's not a great opportunity. All right, my turn for the Defiler of Vigor. All Fair enough. Take four. Take four. Can only block opponent's stuff, right? My opponent's got a good deck, lots of removal and a couple bombs and good filler cards. Is Stronghold Arena good? I think it's okay. It depends on your deck. It clearly was not that good in this game because I was the one on the front foot. But it can be good if you, I mean, if you get to activate it a couple times for a few cards, it's strong. Okay. Well, Essence Scatter is good against the Phyrexian Missionary and the Defiler of Vigor. It's not very easy on my mana. Could see this being a good matchup for aggressive sabotage, especially when I'm on the draw. Thought about Smash to Dust against like Captain's Call, but probably a little too weak. They had Captain's Call, the Warhorse, the 2-1 Pegasus. I think it was the previous opponent who had the Samite Herbalist. Though, of course, they could have it. They're playing a white deck. Yeah, I wonder if just a teamer version would be better for this matchup to get access to the two Essence Scatters. But I'll stick to my guns. Turn three, Yavimai Sojourner is pretty sweet. Generally just sweet to have all my colors of mana on turn three. It's also looking to be a good game for aggressive sabotage. Shields are up. Sure, I guess I'll play the Outrider. Well, like, deciding the best turn to play aggressive sabotage is always a little tricky. It's amazing if you can tag their last two cards, but you don't want to risk them being able to empty their hand. But yeah, here I'll try to tag their last two cards. Do I want to play the Meteorite? No. Yeah, baby. Citizen's Arrest and Phyrexian Missionary. That's a good... That is a good, clean two for one. Whenever one or more other creatures die, put a ++1 counter. All right, so I guess I'm going to... Prophecy. Vladiador, thank you for subscribing. Okay, well, I definitely want the Vine Shaper Prodigy, and I guess the Sojourner. And then I think I'm just going to chump block because I don't want to... I could make a big trade, but I would lose my one or both of my reach creatures and then be vulnerable to the Connoisseur. Well, naturally, the Defiler of Vigor is the most powerful card. The Myria's Outrider is good against Singer Connoisseur. I mean, I think I'm just going to take the Defiler. But I am still going to cast the Sojourner. 5, 6, 7, 8. And then I played my land there so that if I draw another land, I can play Meteorite and Defiler in the same turn. Unclear if I want to Meteorite the Juniper Order Rootweaver because it would add another counter to the Sengir Connoisseur. So I guess I'm inclined to just play Defiler pass. And let's find some action. Okay, interesting. That's not action, come on. I only have four lands left in my deck. Ugh. And that would have been great last turn. So the next two turns, my opponent's going to have two Defiler of Vigors, their own plus mine. Just trying to figure out if I can make any attacks here. Such a bad spot. Thank you. two for one myself to kill the Sengir Connoisseur. This is the card that I probably need if I'm gonna win this game, because on a stalled board, you know, if I get them to start chump blocking with the soldiers. I don't know that I have a real way to actually win this game, especially. All right. Oh, I thought you could choose to cycle the inscribed tablet. That's my mistake. Yeah, I think that card's pretty bad. Inscribed tablet. No, because the inscribed tablet, you reveal the cards. You don't just cast them, or you don't just look at them. I think my opponent's just sitting around trying to deck me, which is a good plan, but, you know, maybe there's some world where I can steal one with Enthrall to the Pit. Not anymore. So I have three cards in my library. One of them is Tail Swipe. 3, 6, 7, 10, 13, 14, 15, 16 land. So I have one land, one Tail Swipe, and I think one green creature. Still just biding my time. It's probably gonna have to be like Irona's Vortex, the Warhorse, and then Enthrall to the Pit, a Defiler, play a green creature, attack with everything, and win over the course of two turns. They have 13 cards in their library. That's trivial. Or irrelevant, perhaps, is the word I should use. All right, so I'm going to end of turn do the Vortex on the Warhorse and then hope something happens. Thrall to the Pit on the big Defiler. Play the Sentry. Make their Snare Spinner not block. And let's see what happens. Oh, interesting suggestion in chat that I could have just Rona's Vortexed my own Defiler back to my hand. But I would have to get rid of the Warhorse in order to do that. So I could have enthralled the Warhorse and bounced my own Defiler. Unclear if that's better. I guess it is. I guess that would be, well, because I don't get the big trample haste creature in that case. So it would have to be more of a long run plan. All right, so then I end my turn. I get one attack left, and I have Tail Swipe as my top card. It's not impossible. Also, I could just... Oh, no. It would be unlikely for me to die this turn. So they're against these five attackers, they need seven blockers because Rada's Firebrand can remove one and Tail Swipe can remove one. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to throw it in full control mode and I'm going to declare my attack. Going to attack and have the Firebrand make Snare Spinner not block. Once that resolves, now I'm going to Tail Swipe the Beast Caller and the Soldier Token. Could it be? I used every card in my library to get to this point. Is it good enough? Thank you. Why did I tail swipe before blockers? Because if they just block and then spend removal spells on the unblocked creatures, it's too late to use the tail swipe. Wow, I cannot believe I won that game and that match. It was, I don't know, I think it was against the odds, but still alive, I guess, still fighting. That enthrall to the pit was the secret sideboard tech. I actually have four badgers. I think I main decked three and then sometimes sideboard out a couple more. All right, welcome back, match number three. There's one of the bog badgers. Is this hand keepable? I guess if I just rattle off lands, then I can play some green creatures. Well, let's rattle off lands, please. Nope. Okay, so they're going to show me four creatures. I'm going to choose the ones that I don't want them to have. They'll get the other two. Okay, I think I want to shuffle away Tatiova and Territorial Marrow. The Marrow is like just very scary for what I have, so I don't have a way to kill it. The Deathbloom Gardener is a bit annoying, but in theory I can use Cut Down once I find black mana. Come on. Not this again. Yep. Good game. I don't think I really like Inscribed Tablet. I think it's just not a very good card. I'm really starting to wonder if this deck does just want to be teamer to get the Essence Scatters. The black rares and the Shadow Prophecy are really good. Maybe I can just get one nice, easy game where Defiler of Vigor goes unanswered and runs away with everything. So I was thinking about playing the Sojourner and then trying to wait till land number six to do Defiler plus Snare Spinner. But now that they've lost their Death Touch creature and they can't have Bite Down or Tail Swipe, it's only a pretty specific selection of cards that can kill the Defiler. I think there's enough chance that this is going to survive that it's worth just playing it out. It's really like just the Extinguish the Light, Rona's Vortex. Oh man. This is such a bold attack. I hate to get punked like this, but I'm gonna take it. Good attack. Good attack from the opponent. Four, five, six, seven. So they could be representing the Indestructible plus Death Touch card. they could be representing any effect that gives, like, you know, in between minus four and minus five. Okay, that's destroy evil. But it could have just been a stone bluff. I mean, I think it's a good opportunity for a bluff. I feel like I have to try. Man, everything was looking good until my opponent found that white mana. But, yep. Alright, I think that ends my sealed deck run.